Hi students, in the last class we saw the problems on the journal entries, how to pass the journal entries. Okay, so there are different journal entries are there. Okay, so now we will see the problem number 4. Journalize the following transaction in the books of Venkatesh in 2012. Okay, so these are the transactions, chronological order is given. Okay, so the March 1st 2012. Okay, so the transaction is given, so we have to pass the journal entries in the books of the journal. Okay, so now put the heading here. So journal entries in the books of the Venkatesh in 2012, like this we have to put the heading. Okay, so now we have to draw the columns, date column, particular column, LF column is the ledger folio column, the debit amount column and the credit amount column. Okay, so now see the March 1st, okay, 1st March. Business started with cash rupees 1 lakh. Okay, so this is the transactions. In the transactions there are two accounts are affecting. Which are those two accounts? Okay, so capital account and the cash account is affecting. Okay, so now what will be the transactions? Cash account debit ₹1 lakh to capital account credit ₹1 lakh. Okay, so being business started with the cash. Okay, so next March 2nd, goods purchased from Manisha ₹3 lakh. Okay, sorry, 30,000 goods purchased from Manisha ₹30,000. Okay, so in this transactions there are two accounts are affecting, which is the purchase account and the Manisha account. Okay, purchase account, the Manisha account. Okay, so the purchase account debit ₹30,000 to Manisha account credit ₹30,000. Okay, so because purchase it is the debit, why it is debit? Because it will come under the nominal account, and what's the nominal rules? Debit all expenses and losses, credit all income and gains. Okay, and so Manisha it is a credit because it is the artificial, it is a natural person and it come under the personal account. And what's the personal rule? Debit is the receiver, credit is the giver. Okay, so it's the giver, it means purchase from Manisha. Okay, so Manisha is a giver, so being goods purchased from Manisha. Okay, so next transaction is what's on 3rd March, opened a bank account with SBI ₹25,000. Okay, so opened a bank account. Okay, so opened a bank account means what? With opening of the bank accounts with the cash. Okay, so they are going to open with the cash. Okay, with the SBI. Okay, so this is the SBI is a particular name of the bank. Okay, so in these transactions there are two accounts are affecting, bank account and the cash account. Okay, bank account and the cash account. Okay, so SBI bank account. Okay, so now how to pass the journal entries? So SBI bank or the bank account debit to cash account credit. Okay, so bank is the receiver. Okay, so while opening the accounts at that time the business is paying cash. Okay, so is the bank is a receiver. Again, cash goes out from the business. Okay, so that's why it's the credit. Okay, being opened a bank account with the cash. Okay, so the next transaction is what? 5th March, cash sales ₹40,000. Okay, so cash sales ₹40,000, it means what? So it is a sales account, it is a sales transactions. Okay, so there are two accounts are affecting, the cash account and the sales account. Okay, so the cash account debit to sales account credit. Okay, so sales it will come under the nominal accounts, and the nominal accounts is what's the rules? Debit all expenses and credit, expenses and losses, credit all income and gains. Okay, so sales it is in the income. Okay, so that's why it is what's the credit. Is it clear? Okay, so the next transaction is what's, so we 7th one, purchased the goods for cash ₹30,000 from Radha. Okay, or you can say the Radha, what's the particular name, is the mistake, the ring on 5th, no. Okay, so on which date? On 7th March, what's the transactions here? It's not purchase account debit to cash account credit ₹30,000 because it is the cash transactions. Okay, being goods purchased for cash. Okay, so there it is a cash transaction. So here purchased goods for cash ₹30,000 from Radha. Okay, so here cash is mentioned, that's why there are two accounts are affecting, purchase account and the cash account. Okay, so the next transactions on 8th March, sold goods to Priya worth ₹40,000 on credit. Okay, so this is the sales transactions and this is the credit transactions. Okay, so particular name is given and here mentioned the credit. Okay, so it is the credit transactions. Okay, so in these transactions there are two accounts are affecting, which are those? Priya account and the sales account. Okay, so Priya account debit ₹40,000 to sales account credit ₹40,000. Okay, so business going to sell to the Priya, and Priya is a receiver. Okay, and sales it is the income, so it is a credit. Okay, so it will come under the nominal and it will come under the personal. Okay, so being goods sold to Priya. Okay, so the next transaction is what's on a 10th March received a check from Priya for rupees 30,000. Okay, what's received a check? Okay, so received a check means what's from Priya. Okay, so cash received and cash, this cash and the Priya account. Okay, so now see which are those two accounts are affecting. So cash account and the Priya account. Okay, so March 10th cash account debit to Priya account credit. Okay, so these are the two accounts are affecting, being check received. While receiving, at that time we have to take the cash, and while paying, at that time we have to take the bank account. Okay, so don't get confused in the check. Okay, while business receiving, at that time we have to take the cash account, and while paying by the check, then you have to take the bank account. Okay, so next in the C, so on 12th March paid check to Manisha rupees 25,000. So see in this. Okay, so received a check, it means what? Cash comes in a business. Okay, so by the Priya. So but paid check means what? Who is going to pay? So business is going to pay by the bank. Okay, so in these transactions there are two accounts are affecting, bank account and the Manisha account. Okay, so Manisha account debit on 12th, Manisha account debit to bank account credit rupees 25,000, being check paid. Okay, so next, on the next transactions, on 19th March paid office rent rupees 5,000. Okay, paid means what? Paid cash paid. Okay, so what? For the office rent. Okay, so rent account debit to cash account credit. Okay, so now this is the transactions here. Office rent account debit rupees 5,000 to cash account credit rupees 5,000, being office rent paid. Okay, so next here, next transactions, 22 March received a commission from Ravi rupees 2,000. Okay, so received a commission from Ravi. Okay, so commission received means what's received? So cash received. Okay, what? Cash received from the Ravi. Okay, so in these transactions there are two accounts are affecting, which are those two accounts? Okay, so see here, cash account and the commission account. Okay, or Ravi account. Cash account debit because commission received, it means cash comes in a business. Okay, by the commission it will come under the nominal account, because what's the nominal rules? Debit all expenses and losses, credit all income and gain. So commission, it is the income. Okay, so it is the received, that's why it is a credit. Okay, so next transaction is what's on 25th, cash withdraw for personal use rupees 2,000. Okay, what's cash withdraw for personal use? Okay, so in these transactions there are two accounts affecting, which are cash withdraw for personal. What's the personal? If it is cash, if it is owner withdraw from money from the business for his personal, is nothing but the drawing account. Okay, it is nothing but the drawing. Okay, so in these transactions there are two accounts are affecting, drawing account and the cash account. Okay, so now see here, on 25th March drawing account debit rupees 2,000 to cash account credit rupees 2,000. Okay, being cash withdrawn for personal use. Okay, so next transactions, last second one transaction is what's on 28th March paid wages rupees 1,000. Okay, paid wages, paid means what? Paid cash paid. Wages means it is one of the type of the salary. Okay, so it is the expenses. Okay, so wages account debit to cash account credit. Okay, so wages, it will come under the nominal, and so what's the nominal rules? Debit all expenses. Okay, so it is the expenses, that's why it is a debit. Okay, while paying the wages, it is cash goes out, so it will come to the real, and what's the real rule? Debit debit what comes in, credit what goes out, and so cash goes out for the payment. Okay, so it is a credit. Okay, being cash paid for wages. So next month is a what's last month, interest received rupees 4,000. Interest received means what's received? Cash received. Okay, so cash account debit to interest account credit. Okay, so this is the transactions, cash account debit to interest account credit rupees 4,000. Okay, being interest received. So now like this, we have to pass the journal entries. So make it total of the debit column and the total of the credit column. Okay, so the total of the debit column is 3,34,000, and the total also is the credit column is 3,34,000. Like this we have to solve. Okay, so I hope you will get understand. If you have any doubt with this lecture, or any you have the query or doubt of the previous lecture also, you can ask me. Okay, so thank you.